cutting the number of Russian Red Wings to 5 and prompted Scotty Bowman to do what no other NHL coach had been able to do. In certain situations, ice a team of 5 Russians and 1 goalie, and not just any 5 Russians, but 5 internationally renowned stars. No matter how they have been used, the Russians have had a lot to do with one of the best regular seasons in NHL history, as the Wings try for their record-tying 60th win tonight. They are the subject of a TSN Inside Sports documentary report, Soviet Reunion, the Russian Red Wings.
He breaks down with Kozlov.
Sergei Fedorov. Igor Larionov. Vyacheslav Kozlov. Vladimir Konstantinov. Vyacheslav Batisov. 5 exceptional Russians playing on a National Hockey League club. While Soviet players have been making their mark in the NHL since the late 1980s, their individual performances have never quite captured the mercurial quality of the team-oriented Russian game. There was a time when we feared the Russians were coming. With this season's incarnation of the Detroit Red Wings, they finally arrived. Until the late 1980s, unforgettable Cold War battles were waged on ice. We were torn between resentment and admiration for the Soviets' seemingly robotic discipline and their flat displays of emotion. On both sides of the Iron Curtain, it was unthinkable that Russians might play in North America.
I know I'm playing with 3 different generations of hockey players, and all of them was skillful and fast, and they can play any league in the world, but you know, its system, communist system, didn't allow them to play anywhere else outside of Soviet Union.
For most of the 1980s, Vyacheslav Fetisov and Igor Larionov served the Soviet national team as part of a 5-man unit. While North American coaches are perpetually juggling 3-man forward lines and defensive pairings, Soviet coaches, the legendary Viktor Tikhonov in particular, have long been working with 5-man units. In the 80s, the Soviets had Krutov, Larionov, and Makarov, the famous KLM line, backed up by Kazatonov and Fetisov. The Soviet Big Five played together 8 years, in 2 Olympics and 8 World Championships.
We've been playing only for gold medals. Even silver medals was a big tragedy for us.
Slava Fetisov and Igor Larionov were the first to break free from Viktor Tikhonov and the tyrannical Russian hockey system. Out of respect for the Russian people, they waited until the system bowed to Glasnost, Mikhail Gorbachev's mandate for social reform.
People in the Soviet Union, I mean, they love the hockey team, and he was like a hero there. I have many chances and opportunities to escape and defect, but it's what my priority, and doesn't know what to do. And the system was expect for me those, because you know they can tell people, you see, we raise him, we give him everything, they, you know, and finally he's exchanged, you know, homeland for the dollars, and you know, it's I cannot put myself in this position.
They endured threats. Sticks and pucks were the only things that distinguished the Red Army Hockey Club from the Red Army.
I never handled a gun, I don't know how to shoot, but you know, I've been in the army, I have a rank who can help me. And Minister of Defense last time called me up and said, you know, you have to be quiet, and otherwise I can send you, you know, pretty far, you never, everybody forget about you.
A generation of nearly 50 Russian NHL players are reaping the benefit of their actions. They miss their homeland, and they worry about its future.
I always think Russia is home, because I see many people in North America very proud of where they born, where they became, to be here or there. Even my teammates, you know, they're very proud of where they come from, you know, even small little towns in North Canada.
Russia's changing, but it's upcoming election, and you don't know what's going to happen. And people who is old, they angry in the system and when the communist back, and it's going to be a scary moment.
I just wish the country will follow the good steps of a free market economy and the freedom.
I have grave of my, grave of my relatives there, and I have roots there, and I have to be back. We always fight for freedom, and we never have this before in Soviet Union, but now, all human beings, they have to have a chance in life to choose what they want to do.
In 1989, Igor Larionov landed in Vancouver. In New Jersey, Slava Fetisov encountered teammates who didn't want Russians taking NHL jobs.
It was very difficult. It's language barrier and culture and all this stuff. It was a big, big problem in the beginning, and different system. Team was playing when I start with, and coaches and all this stuff, and even partners, and I know now they hate me, my partners, my dressing room, they hate me because I was coming.
Igor Larionov has a diplomatic memory.
I'm just glad, and Slava and I, we made this kind of opportunity for the younger guys to be playing National Hockey League, enjoying the lifestyle, and make a history.
The Detroit Red Wings management has been the most aggressive of all NHL clubs in acquiring Russian talent. The team now has more Russians than any other. Russian players constitute nearly a quarter of the roster and a third of their recent draft picks. Scott Bowman must have learned something from the three defeats he endured in international tournaments against Soviet teams, but the Red Wings coach downplays his strategy in assembling the first five-man unit in the history of the NHL.
The team has had Sergei Fedorov and Slava Kozlov and Vladimir Konstantinov. Last year we made the addition of Vyacheslav Fetisov at the deadline, and it really helped because we were, we needed some depth in defense, and then he came back this year and has had an excellent season. We made the trade for Igor Larionov on the fact that we knew what he was like because we played San Jose the last 2 years, and he was a quality player. That was very creative, and then when we did get them, we decided that these five players play a unique style, and we could put them together on most occasions.
Others see Bowman's intentions differently.
That was kind of his idea, his dream about, to put five Russians together.
He hasn't really said it, but it's almost seemed like it's kind of like it's been his goal to put that kind of a unit together, and when the chance came to get Larionov, he jumped at it.
One day he was thinking, obviously some power to maybe make this dream come through.
I think it's a pride thing with Scotty, even though he says no. I think it's something that he thought would be a great byproduct of this trade, is that he could be the first coach in the National Hockey League to put together a five-man unit of Russians.
I never dreamed to play in the same, in the Russian unit and play for the team who have like red colors, Detroit Red Wings. So it's like be back in the red uniform again.
I'll be perfectly honest with you. When we got Igor and knew we were going to put the unit together, I mean, we were, a little bit skeptical because we just didn't want our dressing room to be divided. We didn't want to have the five Russians and the rest of the guys. But these five guys are great, great human beings, great hockey players.
I was a little bit nervous because first time ever in the National Hockey League, they're five-man unit will play together, and a lot of expectation, a lot of pressure.
In the beginning, the English and Russian languages competed in the Red Wings dressing room. Paul Coffey approached Slava Fetisov.
It wasn't a hardball thing or anything like that. I just felt that, if we're going to communicate on the same ice out there, that we, if at all possible, should try to speak the same language.
Bowman plays his five-man unit together for the first time October 27, 1995. They play like blood brothers, delivering on their second shift.
Edward Tuck hits it, rebound, score!
House Detroit Red Wings five-man Russian unit is symbiotic in scoring, but each man has a strikingly distinct talent and personality. Sergei Fedorov may be the most gifted among them.
Ah, Sergei Fedorov.
He is the first Russian to win both the Hart and Frank J. Selke trophies.
It was a great experience, and I probably feel I was most happiest person in the world.
Does Sergei dream of winning the Hart this year? Yes, but for now he's keeping that hope under his hat, literally. When Slava Fetisov is asked to compare his best years to the performance of Fedorov now, he doesn't hesitate.
He's better than I, that's for sure. I know it's got tremendous skill and skating ability. It's unbelievable.
I don't know. Depends how much skill you got on you.
Sergei is that rare commodity among players. He is as fluid skating backward as forward most of the time. What has it meant to Sergei to play with his boyhood heroes, Slava Fetisov and later Igor Larionov?
It was amazing. Never thought in my deepest dreams, or if people would tell me 10 years ago I will be in that playing North America with those people, I said, come on, get a laugh, you know, leave me alone or something like that, you know.
The veterans were equally excited.
He shoots, he scores!
He's one of the best hockey players in the National Hockey League today. And of course, when I arrived in this team, and this was a thrill for me to play with Sergei.
Both as a unit and when mixing with other lines, the Russians have become the main force on this Red Wings roster. Sergei Fedorov, with the crucial support of veteran superstars Steve Yzerman and Paul Coffey, is perhaps the man more than any other who is to carry the Wings on his shoulders this spring.
You're the first person who told me that, but I like that. I think I like that pressure. I like people saying that because it just motivate me to play better.
Gifted goal scorer Vyacheslav Kozlov is a spirited but intensely shy man. He struggles both with culture shock and with the lasting impact of a car accident in Moscow that took the life of a teammate and nearly cost him his own life.
I spent three months in the hospital in Moscow. When I was in Russia, I was like a fancy player over there, big star, and sometimes I make some mistakes, you know. And when I came here, changed my life.
Kazi, as he prefers to be called, may always wonder.
If I don't have a car accident, maybe I play better than I am right now.
Defenseman Vladimir Konstantinov currently leads the league in the plus-minus category. But for a team-oriented Russian, individual statistics mean little.
It doesn't matter plus minus, because it's more important now play like defensive hockey, because it's playoffs hockey.
Number 16 serves his defense by any means necessary.
But Konstantinov playing the role of Ty Cobb.
Konstantinov is dangerous on offense when opportunity knocks. This disarmingly gentle fellow walks softly, but he skates with a big stick.
People say they can say whatever they want. I want to play like aggressive style hockey and play tough game against like everybody. Doesn't matter if he is star or not.
His team is Slava Fetisov, whom many have called the Bobby Orr of Russia, is the self-deprecating and eloquent elder statesman of this five-man unit.
Slava has such a presence, he's such a class act, that it doesn't matter what country he's playing in or what line of work he was in, that he has such an aura around him, that he's a natural leader and people will gravitate towards him because he's articulate and very bright and worldly.
Now in the final years of his storied career, Slava has reveled in the opportunity to play with this historic five-man unit.
When I stopped clicking, it was lots of fun here, and guys get their memory back, and especially for myself, and probably for you too, to get those feelings back. It was just unbelievable, and we had fun, and I didn't feel my age now.
In Russia, they call Igor Larionov the professor. Now he's adored by his students at Red Wings University.
He helped progress my game. I can jump up more than I used to be, and I can rush the attack too, because when Igor gets the puck, I knew he gave to me pass all the time.
In previous seasons, Kozlov was one Red Wings scorer to watch. This season, with the support of Larionov, he can be the hottest scorer on a given night.
He helped me a lot on the ice and in my life too.
My game is simple, you know. I'm playing my role in this unit, like be a link between forwards and defense. So I play like dispatcher or conductor.
He told me, don't worry, relax. We start play each other, and I start score the goals.
It's the biggest thing is he's kind of put them all together, all five guys, and they've grown together since he's got here and got even better as the seasons went on.
Closest thing to Wayne Gretzky. They have the same size, they see the ice as well. They both make great, great passes.
Exceptional individual talents, these Russian Red Wings stand out when they're deployed on any line. In the five-man unit, these stars shine more brightly when they form the ever-varying constellations that result in their goals. Even when they retreat or lose possession of the puck, it's hard to escape thinking they're in control. If we must choose three words to describe what's in the four of the five-man unit's collective mind, they would be these. Team, team, team.
This name, and it doesn't matter what they have on the back, you know, if you don't think in, for the team, you know, going to produce for the team.
When we got together, so we didn't really like think who's going to be leader of this unit. We're playing for each other. It's a Soviet-Russian style mentality, you know. Who cares? We're playing for each other, we're playing for the team.
Well, that's different because they pass it back a lot, and they pass it back into our own end quite a few times, and they like to make a lot of cross-ice passes. But they're potent in the opposition's end. I mean, they're hard to keep track of. I mean, once they give it away, they're so good away from the puck, and that's what makes them so good.
It's been an honor, really. It's been a lot of fun to sit back and watch these guys, you know, let alone in games, in practices. Their ability is in conditioning is so superior.
They play a different brand of hockey than we play. And we're more of an up and down, straight ahead with the puck, and they like to do a lot of crisscrossing and zigzagging and whatnot. So they're a nice change for our team, and they offset the other lines in our team and give the other team something different to look at.
These five Russians have contributed more than a third of their team's goals and total points. They are the nucleus of a club that is not just the runaway President's Trophy winner for 1995-96, but one of the best regular season NHL teams ever assembled. Now the Russian Red Wings have their eyes on the prize, the Stanley Cup.
The most gorgeous part of it when you really, you know, have the trophy in your hands.
I dream about the Stanley Cup and no, it's something else.
Stanley Cup means for me, like, I think everything, because it's just one title left I want to win.
I won the Olympics and the World Championships, and you're playing just 10 games or 8 games tournament. This is going to be like marathon, playing 82 game season and then playing 4 rounds in the playoffs.
I never won Stanley Cup, and it's probably tough tough to compare, but it's all best players now play here, and everybody want to be the winner, and everybody dreams to win the cup.
There's best teams on a planet, on the world, you know, and of course I would be so happy if it happened this year, and it would be like the best memory for me to win the Stanley Cup.
This photograph of the 1954-55 Stanley Cup champions hangs prominently in the Detroit Red Wings dressing room. 1996 offers the team a great opportunity to hang another team picture beside it. For the Russian Red Wings, the achievement will be special. It will be the closest the Red Army has ever come to winning professional hockey's Holy Grail. More importantly, though, it will send a resounding message home that the Glasnost dreams of freedom and success, at least for these exceptional five, came true. Goals as a team, the five Russians have combined for more than 300 scoring points, and short of trying to determine exactly how many goals have been scored with the involvement of one or more of the Russians, let's just say it's plenty, and that goes for the goals scored with the exclusive involvement of Russians too. They could have their own highlight reel of goals scored after intricate passing plays, and it could serve as the league's best. Once upon a time, an NHL team with such a Russian flavor would have been unthinkable. And at a later time, after it did become possible, it would have been questioned or criticized. And I suppose you can still hear some of that. But if you pay big dollars for an NHL ticket at Joe Louis Arena, surely you want to see the kind of hockey that these guys can play, especially when they're on the ice together. That's our last word for tonight. Hope you enjoyed Soviet Reunion, the Russian Red Wings. Thanks for watching TSN Inside Sports.
Castrol brings you the Dave Hodge Commentary, heard daily across Canada on the TSN Sports Radio Network. Castrol GTX, the oil engineered for greater protection against breakdowns.